All right. Still. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Zoopraxographical Hall here at the Columbian Exposition. The building you are now standing in was designed and built solely for the purpose of presenting to you the magic of the Zoopraxiscope, which you see to my right. This is the only machine in the world that can project moving images of photographs taken from your life. Ladies and gentlemen, prepare yourself for a sight you have never seen before. If you please, sir. I present you the Zoopraxiscope. My dearest Flora, you, my wife, know better than anyone my devotion to my profession. The documentation of these Modoc Indian fighters and their rural American infantry counterparts in this barren desert land is abstract. I long for the technical innovations I know are coming. What would the man pulling the trigger say when able to view his own face in that moment of violence? What would the governments and leaders sending these men to their death over a strip of desert land say if they could see the irrefutable evidence of the exact moment of their soldiers' deaths? Instead, I take the same steady shots. Any movement, a blur in time.
The defense will argue a period temporal insanity. Well, one moment no longer leads to the next. In this state, neither time nor the expectations of society meant anything. I do not ask you to send him forth to home and family. He has none. Across the arch of his fireplace, for once were written the words, home, wife, child, content, and peace. There now appears, as a substitute for all, in black letters placed there by the destroyer, the single awful word, desolation. But I can ask you to send him forth free. To pick up again the thread of his broken life, to resume that profession upon which his genius has shed so much luster, that profession which is now his only love. Do this, but this, and from every peaceful household and from every quiet home across the state, there will come to your verdict the echo of a deep and solemn amen.
Still?